Hello YouTubers, how's it going? This is the trailing arm, and this is what the back of the trailing arm looks like. And the plan was to obviously strip it down into its little component parts and then get it stripped down. It's got surface rust, but luckily there's no structural rust. However, I thought these dust shields had a slot in them so you could take them off, but you can't actually remove these. But in order to take this off, you've got to take the hub off. To take the hub completely off, which includes the bearing, you've got to remove this nut here. And on top of that as well, this is my least favorite fixing of all time. It looks like an Allen key, but it's actually I don't know if you can see that, star drive. And there's nothing worse than rusty star drives, sockets, or socket headed bolts with a star drive on it, or spline drive, sorry, whatever you want to call them, because I've already tried one after soaking it in penetrant oil. They just round out, so can't take that off. I doubt even this will want a turn. This is 30 years old. This hasn't been apart in 30 years. Luckily the bearing is good, absolutely smooth and silent. This is still, it's got surface rust on it, but it looks like I'm going to end up having to paint this while it's still on the arm. At least I can swivel it around. The only other possibility is to cut maybe a slot all the way up there and all the way up there, because it's held on by four bolts anyway. Is to cut a slot and then just pull it off that way. I don't know. Having said that, I think, judging by the angle of that, you see that, I'd have to cut the slot from up here, which means removing two fixings. That will make it weak. So no, it looks like I'm going to end up having to de-rust this while it's on the wheel hub. So that's, it's the little things like that that take time. Obviously this centre bush, this main unit here, I'm going to have to drill that out, because that has never been apart in 30 years, and that will put up a hell of a fight. These are just bolt-on links. They come up, they're usually sold as a pair, or sold as a complete unit. There's a bush there, there's a bush there. This is basically a Honda setup on the Rover, so there's lots of suspension bushes and linkages and everything else. These are the heat shields for the top of the calipers. Typical Rover, they're unobtainium. I'm not sure if Honda still do these as well. If they do, then I'm going to look on the various websites. But look at that, the metal's thin. I might try and replicate it, a simplified shape, because it protects the handbrake mechanism. I'll show you why. Bear with us a minute. I'm trying to do this one-handed. This part here, it sits, it kind of, well, it sits over there anyway. It's not, obviously it's turned the other way, but that projection there protects moisture from getting into the handbrake mechanism. When that seizes up, the pads will essentially lock onto the discs and you end up with a seized caliper, and that's a complete pain in the watsit to sort out. So I need to replicate or find a pair of these. That's how they sit on the car, like that. That's got quite a complex shape to try and replicate. Bearing in mind I don't have any shrinker stretchers or bead rollers or anything like that, I'm going to have to work something out. As I said, these are the little things, these are the little details that kind of delay everything, because it seems minor, but you realise that to do that, or to work on this, then you can't put this back on the car until the bushes are done, but you can't do the bushes until the painting is done, and you can't do the painting until you've taken it all apart and managed to degrease it and everything. Anyway, that's what I'm up against, and you'll see the other videos I've recently put up. And so there you go. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.